Hello everyone, welcome back to LawSikho. Today we have with us Prabal Goel, who is a banking, finance and a private equity lawyer.
So sir, as we all know that stamp duty is a very confusing part of structuring your documents. Yeah. Can you give our audiences an overview of the stamp duty on the loan agreements and the security documents?
So again, since these are covered by state list under Constitution of India, the applicability of stamp duty would vary across the geography of the nation. And this gives a lot of room for arbitrage. So for instance, in Maharashtra, for instance, if you have an unsecured loan, the stamp duty implication is typically very high. That is not the case if the loan agreements are being executed in places like Delhi, for instance. Now, even how do you choose a venue of execution is also a subject matter of debate. There have been case laws in the past which have stated that while you could probably sign loan agreements anywhere, in case of secure documents which need to be filed with the registrar of companies, they would be deemed to have been brought into the state in which the security is in which the registered office of the company is situated. So irrespective of where you sign them, the stamp duty impact will be governed by two factors. Where the security itself is situated. This would be more relevant in case of a more property. The second factor which is crucial is where the registrar of companies is situated. So for instance, to give you an example, if you are looking to create mortgage in a plot of land in Maharashtra and the registered office of the company is located in Delhi, despite the fact that the stamp duty in Delhi is much lower than that in Maharashtra, you would have to eventually pay the stamp duty which is applicable to the state of Maharashtra. So apart from these two, you would also have to see as to what the individual, you know, what the individual aspects of stamp duties are. Typically, in case of pledge of shares, the stamp duty on pledge of listed shares tends to be very low because of presence of a provision which is typically found either in Section 23A of the respective States Act or Section 24 of the respective State Stamp Acts, so which allows you to, you know, bypass the high stamp duty which is stipulated in the schedules of the Stamp Act.